Parallel editing or cross-cutting is when the film alternates between two or more lines of action that are happening simultaneously. Oftentimes it's used to create suspense, so what's happening in different places at the same time. One of the best examples that I like in terms of suspense is in The Silence of the Lambs. The FBI comes to the house of who they think the killer is. So we see them all outside. There's a decoy, there's the guy who's ringing the bells, and the action cuts into the interior of a house where the killer is, and we see that the killer is hearing the doorbell ringing. It cuts back to the outside, them waiting, cuts back to him, he hears the doorbell ring again. He's moving up to open the door, and when he opens the door, it's Clarice who's outside, and Clarice is alone. So all of a sudden you realize that these were two different houses. It was the house where the FBI thought that the killer was, and they're wrong, and the house that Clarice is just visiting in terms of gathering more information. So all of a sudden, you were not necessarily thinking that this was a suspenseful sequence, but then you feel a lot of tension because you realize that she's in front of the killer and no one is there to have her back. Another example that I would like to talk about is the ending of The Hour of the Star. It's a Brazilian film by Susana Amaral. It's the story of Macabea, a young woman who have migrated into Rio de Janeiro, who's poor, who's uneducated, and she's at the fortune teller. And the fortune teller starts to tell her that her life is gonna change, that she's gonna meet a man who's gonna change her life. And she starts to say, this is a really good-looking man, a very rich man. Then the film cuts to these images of this young man, wealthy, and he just gets in his car and starts driving. The action goes back and forth between Macabea leaving the house of the fortune teller and the guy driving in the freeway very fast. Goes back to her, she goes outside, and she's walking on the street. It's showed in slow motion. So then he's going fast, she's just walking slowly, and goes back and forth between the two actions, and by the time that the two actions come together, he runs over her. and leaves her dead in the street. She found her happiness, right? But the happiness came at the expense of her life was so miserable and people didn't care about poor people as much as they should, that death became the one solution for her life.